Hi, I'm in Angels in North London, Europe's largest costumier. They supply outfits to Hollywood films and to television programs. There's 8 miles of different outfits here. We've got military, we've got jazz, we've got modern day, we've got cavemen. And their latest project they're working on is Downton Abbey, set in the First World War.
We've always liked dressing up since time began. Victorian days, Queen Victoria and all of that, we used to do these tableau vivants or whatever they were, and you had all these coming out. You had the Chelsea Arts Ball, which was big, and people liked dressing up. I suppose it's a way of escaping.
How about that? What I love about Angels is that it's been going for so long that a lot of the outfits, when they bought them, they were of course cutting-edge contemporary fashions. They're now used in period drama. And the company keeps on buying new stuff, contemporary 1980s shell suits, 1990s suits.
We've got stuff, we've got a few bits and bobs going back to the 1690s, but we wouldn't use them. You shouldn't actually notice the clothes, and you know, that's another thing about making. Some of these things don't look real because they have been made. And everything has been made, and it doesn't look right.
This is for Dad's Army. The best thing about this place is the dressing up. Here I am as Colin Firth in the King's Speech. It's lovely. And this is what Charlton Heston wore in The Prince and the Pauper. It's very heavy. And this is the outfit that Sean Bean wore when he was playing Sharp in the TV series. Crucially, this is the knackered version after battle. And this is what Alan Leach playing Branson, the rebellious chauffeur in Downton Abbey wore. Off for a drive, Lady Sybil? Who knows? One day, this outfit could end up in here and then on a TV screen near you.